After our video on the anatomy of a permanent mandibular central incisor, let's shift our focus on the anatomy of a permanent mandibular lateral incisor. The two incisors operate in the dental arch as a team, therefore their functional form is related. However, there are certain features which differentiate a permanent mandibular central incisor from that of a lateral incisor. Watch the video till the end to understand the anatomy of a permanent mandibular lateral incisor. Hi, we at Dentorize welcome you all to a platform where we help you to conceptualize, visualize and memorize dentistry. The right and the left mandibular lateral incisors, which are also called as the second incisors, are present in contact with the central incisor mesially and with the canines distally. According to the FDI tooth notation system, the permanent right mandibular lateral incisor is numbered as 4-2 and the permanent left mandibular lateral incisor is numbered as 3-2. Following the similar approach, we will be discussing the anatomy of a permanent mandibular lateral incisor under five headings. These are the labial aspect, the lingual aspect, the mesial aspect, the distal aspect and the incisal aspect. Starting with the labial aspect first, considering the first heading, that is the dimensions, the cervico-incisal length as measured from the highest point on the incisal ridge to the lowest point on the cervical line is 9.5 mm. The root length as measured from the lowest point on the cervical line till the root apex is 14 mm. Talking about the mesodistal dimensions, the mesodistal dimension as measured from the contact areas is 5.5 mm, while the mesodistal dimensions as measured from the cervix is 4 mm. If we observe closely, we would find that these dimensions of a permanent mandibular lateral incisors are greater in comparison to the dimensions of mandibular central incisor. This is in contrast to that of the maxillary incisors, wherein the dimensions of a permanent maxillary lateral incisor were less in comparison to the dimensions of permanent maxillary central incisor. Apart from the dimensions, there is one more feature that differentiates a permanent mandibular lateral incisor from that of the mandibular central incisor. In a mandibular central incisor, both the mesial and the distal contact areas were present almost at the same level in the incisal third of the crown. In a permanent mandibular lateral incisor, both the mesial and the distal contact areas are present in the incisal third of the crown, but the difference is that the distal contact area is present more cervical than the mesial contact area to make proper contact with the canine which is present distal to it. Coming to the lingual aspect of a permanent mandibular lateral incisor, we would observe that even the lingual aspect of this tooth is similar to the lingual aspect of mandibular central incisor except the dimensions. There is a convexity of the cingulum, concavity of a lingual fossa and inconspicuous marginal ridges present in a mandibular lateral incisor, very much similar to that of the central incisor. Starting with the mesial and the distal aspects of this tooth, we would find that the labiolingual dimensions at the crest of curvature present in the cervical third of the crown is 6.5 mm and the labiolingual dimensions at the cervix is 5.8 mm. Let's discuss in detail about the features of the mesial aspect and distal aspect of this tooth by comparing these two aspects. So, point number one, the mesial side of the crown is often longer than the distal side of the crown. This causes the incisal ridge, which is usually straight, to slope downward in a distal direction, as you can see in the figure. Point number two, this point we have already discussed. The mesial contact area is more towards the incisal ridge than the distal contact area, or conversely we can say that the distal contact area is more towards the cervical line than the mesial contact area. Why? This is because this tooth has to contact properly with the mesial contact area of mandibular canine from the distal side. That is why there is a difference in the levels of the contact areas mesially and distally. Point number three. On observing the distal aspect very carefully, we would find that a tendency exists towards a deeper concavity immediately above the cervical line on the distal aspect of this tooth as compared to that of the mesial aspect. If we talk about the cervical line on both these aspects, we would find that the curvatures of cervical line mesially and distally are similar to much extent. coming to the root, we would find that developmental depressions are present on both the mesial and the distal aspect of this tooth, similar to that of the mesial and distal aspect of a permanent mandibular central incisor. Coming to the last and the most important aspect in the anatomy of permanent mandibular lateral incisor, that is the incisal aspect. This aspect provides the most characteristic differentiating feature which helps us to compare between the anatomy of a mandibular lateral incisor from that of the mandibular central incisor. As we have already discussed in the incisal aspect of a permanent mandibular central incisor, the incisal ridge is present at right angles to the line bisecting the crown labiolingually. However, in the anatomy of a permanent mandibular lateral incisor from the incisal aspect, the incisal ridge is not at right angles to the line bisecting the crown labiolingually, as you can see in the figure. This edge follows the curvature of mandibular dental arch, which gives the crown of mandibular lateral incisor the appearance of being slightly twisted on its root base. There is one more important point that has to be observed here. Even though the incisal ridges are not directly in line, but the labiolingual root axis of mandibular central incisor and lateral incisor remain almost parallel in their alveolar process. So, we saw that not much differences are present in the anatomy of a permanent mandibular lateral incisor from that of mandibular central incisor. Just a difference in dimensions from the labial and lingual aspect, a difference in the contact areas from mesial and distal aspect, and most importantly, difference in the angulation between the incisal edge and the line bisecting the crown labiolingually from the incisal aspect. So what you can do now is, you can differentiate between the anatomy of mandibular central incisor from that of mandibular lateral incisor in the similar way we differentiated between the anatomy of maxillary central incisor from that of maxillary lateral incisor. The link is given in the description box below. You can make your own notes. You can share your notes with us so that we can have a look on your notes and tell you your areas of improvement. It becomes very easy to memorize this way. If you like our content, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever we upload a new video. Suggestions are always welcome from your side. Stay tuned, stay safe. Thank you for watching.